Detroit, Michigan. In the emergency room of Sparrow Hospital in Lansing, Michigan, Pam Warfel begged for compassion. Her son with autism had COVID-19 and needed to be hospitalized, though the staff informed her she couldn't stay. "You don't understand. You're going to have to carry me out of here. He cannot communicate," Warfel recalled telling the doctors and nurses as she pleaded to stay. "You can put me in bubble wrap. I'll stay in a corner. But the hospital wouldn't bend. We cannot do it," they said. In that moment, her 21-year-old son Jonathan, who has always lived with his parents and attends life skills classes, became her hero. "He looked at me and said, 'Mom, it'll be okay,'" Warfel recalled. "I told him, 'I'm scared.'" "Are you scared?" He said, "Mom, I gotta get better." With an ache in her heart and tears in her eyes, she gave him a hug and a kiss, slid his tray of water and ice chips over to him, and left. 3 days later, Warfel was back at the same ER, this time with her 83-year-old mother. However, unlike her grandson, who has no pre-existing conditions, Smith has COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, an inflammatory lung disease that causes obstructed airflow from the lungs. Warfel knew what she was in for. As with her son, she would have to leave her mom at the hospital and advocate from the outside. "She did not want to go in," Warfel recalled of her mother. "She had convinced me she was just tired. She said, 'Pam, I just need to sleep. We can go in the morning.'" But Warfel didn't take any chances. She packed her mother's bags and her mini oxygen tank, got her in the car and had her 20-year-old daughter, Arena, drive them to the hospital. It was about 7 p.m. November 9th when they pulled up to the ER with Leona. Warfel carefully maneuvered her mother out of the car, held her up, and the two walked arm in arm for about 40 feet when a security guard spotted them and asked whether they needed a wheelchair. "She has COVID," Warfel told the guard. "You won't be able to come in, ma'am," she recalled him telling her. With Jonathan, she at least got to go into the ER. This time, she had to leave her mom at the door. As hospital staff wheeled her inside the building, Warfel hollered from afar, "She has her medicine list in her front pocket, with my phone number. And her oxygen tank is only half full." As she got back in the car, pain and sadness set in. Her Jonathan was still inside the hospital building, alone, where nurses were struggling to draw his blood, poking him so many times that they had to call his mom in the middle of the night to keep him calm and talk him through it. He was fighting a virus that had crept into his lungs and wiped him out so badly that he could barely talk when his mom phoned. "It was so hard because all I could do was think of Jonathan," Warfel said. "I'm so close to him, and I had to turn around and leave him again." For 3 weeks, the virus had gripped Warfel in fear and anxiety. She sobbed,